Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are talking about my favorite food in the world, chocolate, and I'm going to be sharing with you guys 6 different healthier chocolate recipes that I make on a regular basis because I eat chocolate on a regular basis and I want to feel good while still being able to enjoy my favorite food. So if you want any of the recipes in this video, be sure to check out the description box where there'll be a free downloadable PDF as well as links to all the recipes. All right, let's jump in. Okay, to start, we are going to make these super simple peanut butter stuffed pretzel bites that are, of course, coated in chocolate. And to make the filling, all you need is some almond flour, a little maple syrup, and some natural peanut butter. You could sprinkle in a little extra sea salt if you want, but the peanut butter is also already salted. So just stir that together until you get a thick, kind of sticky dough. And then you're gonna grab your pretzels and take a little bit of dough, like a teaspoon worth, roll it into a little ball and sandwich it between two pretzels to make a little sandwich. And then you're just gonna do this over and over again until you use up all your peanut butter filling. And then we're gonna just pop this into the freezer while we melt some chocolate. There are two ways you can melt the chocolate for these pretzel bites. One is just by using the microwave. Just put some chocolate chips and a little coconut oil in a bowl and microwave it at 30-second intervals until it's melted. Or like I did here, I just made a double boiler using a small saucepan and a heat-proof bowl. And once your chocolate is melted, you're just gonna take your bites and you could either coat them entirely in the chocolate, shaking off the excess. You could dip them so that half is coated. Or towards the end of this process, I just started drizzling them with chocolate because I've made so many. Anyway is fine, it kind of depends on how much chocolate you have or how much chocolate you want on each bite. So as you can see, I'm just shaking off some of the excess chocolate. And once I used up all my chocolate, I just popped these back in the freezer to harden. And then they were these delicious peanut butter stuffed pretzel bites that we devoured in a matter of days. It was kind of embarrassing how quickly we ate through them, but they are so good. A nice salty crunch from the pretzels, you're gonna love them. Next up is my absolute favorite recipe from this video, and it's for tahini brownies. The amount of times we've made this recipe during quarantine is a little scary, but they're full of natural tahini and a lot of good stuff. So to start, you're gonna use a cup of natural tahini, add in 2 flax eggs, some coconut sugar, maple syrup, baking soda, salt, and then you're gonna whisk this mixture together until it gets pretty thick and sticky. Next, you're gonna pop in some cocoa powder and some chocolate chips and eat one as you go, like I always do. Did you guys know I like chocolate? Because I love chocolate. And then again, you're gonna just stir this until a nice, thick, sticky batter forms. And this is delicious. If you don't like tahini, you'll probably still love these brownies. They are rich and fudgy and taste especially amazing when paired with non-dairy ice cream, which is what we've been doing. But all you're gonna do is pop this into a greased loaf pan and then bake these in the oven for about 20 minutes. They might not look done at first, but you're gonna let them cool. The center will sink down a little. The outsides will become kind of chewy. The center will be super gooey at first, but once you let them cool, they will just be a fudgy, delicious tahini brownie that you will want to make every week or every night, depending on how many people are in your family. Definitely give this recipe a try. Next up, I'm sharing a healthy breakfast option, and this is for chickpea flour chocolate pancakes. If you've never used chickpea flour, don't be intimidated by it. You should be able to find it at your local grocery store, and it's a great flour to have in your pantry. So I'm gonna start by whisking together all of the dry ingredients, which is chickpea flour, cocoa powder, baking soda, baking powder, and some salt. And you're just gonna whisk this until all of the dry ingredients are combined and there aren't any clumps. Now I'm gonna make the wet mixture, which starts with 2 super ripe bananas. And you're gonna just wanna mash those until they are pretty liquidy before adding in a little maple syrup, apple cider vinegar, which will make these pancakes nice and fluffy, and then some warmed up coconut oil and milk, just so that the coconut oil doesn't harden right away when it hits with the other cold ingredients. And now you're gonna combine the wet and the dry before making these pancakes like you would any other pancakes. If you wanted to make these double chocolate pancakes, you could always pop some chocolate chips into the batter when you're making them. But our favorite toppings are, of course, some fresh fruit, usually banana, but today I had strawberries, some natural peanut butter, and crunchy chocolate granola, which I'll show you how to make right now. It's been so long since I bought store-bought granola, and that's because it's so easy to make it at home yourself. Today I'm going to show you how to make some chocolate granola. And to start, you're going to melt some coconut oil, cocoa powder, and maple syrup in a saucepan over medium heat. Next, in a large mixing bowl, you're going to mix together rolled oats and then about a cup and a half of your favorite nuts, seeds, whatever you have on hand. Just want to make sure they're chopped up into smaller pieces. I love to use a mix of walnuts, pumpkin seeds, and slivered almonds. You're also going to add in some sea salt, and that will bring out more of the rich, chocolatey flavor. And then for a little extra sweetness, you're going to add in some coconut sugar. Now you're going to take that melted coconut oil, maple syrup, and cocoa mixture and pour it over your dry ingredients. And you're going to stir this until all of the oats and the nuts get coated in that nice chocolatey sauce. Once everything's well combined, you're just going to pour this onto a lined baking sheet. I love these silicone baking mats. It keeps my pans nice and just makes for easy cleanup, so I'll link those down below. But you're going to press this down into an even layer and bake it in the oven for about 20 to 24 minutes, flipping it over and giving it a little stir halfway through. And then the trick to homemade granola is to let it cool completely so that it sticks together and makes clusters. So be patient, allow the granola to cool completely before you break it up into clusters and store it in an airtight container. Next up, I'm showing you how to make our favorite chocolate breakfast muffins. These are so healthy and they start with a flax egg, which I thought I would share what that looks like here. And you're gonna whisk that together with some super ripe mashed banana, almond milk, maple syrup, coconut oil, cocoa powder, baking soda, and baking powder. Oh yeah, and some salt until super smooth. Before adding in your different flours. So the base of these muffins is oat flour, so it's kind of like a baked oatmeal muffin, but it also has some almond flour in it as well. So these are gluten-free, made with hearty, wholesome, whole grain ingredients. And once your batter's all ready, you're just gonna divide it among 12 muffin cups. I actually usually make jumbo muffins with these, and we eat one each for breakfast. Otherwise, we need two of these little muffins for a hearty breakfast, but you can make whatever size you want. The baking time will just vary a little bit, but you're gonna bake these in the oven until they are cooked through and warm, and they might not be the prettiest, but they are fluffy and delicious. Next up, I'm sharing some four ingredient chocolate chia seed pudding. And this is one of the most popular recipes on my blog because it's so easy to make. You're just gonna mix some chia seeds with cocoa powder, a touch of maple syrup, and non-dairy milk. And you wanna stir that really well so that no clumps of chia seeds are stuck to your jar. And then you're gonna leave it for about 5 minutes before stirring it again, popping the lid on and placing it in the fridge overnight to thicken. It will look super soupy at first, but as it sits in the fridge, it will thicken up and become a nice, thick, kind of like tapioca pudding. So you could eat this straight from the jar. As you can see, it's super thick, has fun texture. Those little chia seeds absorb a ton of liquid, so they get nice and soft. Or you can transfer it to another jar or bowl, add in some fresh fruit, something crunchy on top makes it really nice. Just so that you have some texture variation and you have a hearty, plant-based, protein-rich breakfast ready to go. Chia seed pudding is also a great recipe to meal prep. You can make a large batch of it and store it in the fridge for a few days. That way you don't have to think about breakfast in the morning, but you can just have a hearty, plant-based breakfast waiting for you when you wake up. All right, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video because I loved making it. Again, all the recipe links can be found down below, as well as a free downloadable PDF. If you want more themed videos like this, or even a whole nother chocolate recipe video, be sure to give this video a like so that I know you enjoyed it. Subscribe so you don't miss the next video, and I'll see you very soon. Bye!